Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever. Trusting in God's grace, let us confess our sin. Loving God, in Christ,
and have peace with you. We know what is good and right, but we do what is hateful and evil. We fail to love our neighbors and fall short of your law of love. We do not share with those in need or extend hospitality to strangers. We ignore the groaning of creation and forget the hope of the gospel. Forgive us, loving God. Pour your spirit into our hearts, that we may live as those who are dead to sin and alive to you.
Nothing can separate us from the love of Christ, neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, nor height nor depth nor anything else in all creation can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Lord.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for planting in us the seed of your word. By your Holy Spirit, help us to receive it with joy, live according to it, and grow in faith and hope and love. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
A reading from Isaiah. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there until they have watered the earth, may it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater. So shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose and succeed in the thing for which I send it. For you shall go out in joy and be led back in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall burst into song, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Instead of the thorn shall come up the cypress. Instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle. And it shall be to the Lord for a memorial, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. was meine Munter geht, o sei, es so nicht wieder zu mir dir komme. Und der Tod, das mir gefällt,
der Mammon auch hat viele
it is in your mouth and in your heart. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to Matthew. That same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat beside the sea. Such great crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat there, while the whole crowd stood on the beach. And he told them many things in parables, saying, "Listen, a sower went out to sow, and in the sowing some seeds fell on the path, and the birds came and ate them up. Other seeds fell on rocky ground where they did not have much soil, and they sprang up quickly since they had no depth of soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched, and since they had no root, they withered away. Other seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. Other seeds fell on good soil, and brought forth grain, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. If you have ears, hear." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Alleluia.
Three weeks into LSM, have you counted up your missed notes? Is that something you care to add to your practice journal, all the notes you've missed? Or would you rather just forget about those missed notes? Today, Jesus tells the story of a sower who misses an awful lot of notes. The notes here, of course, being seeds. This is in stark contrast to our great cantata musicians who dutifully followed Cantor Bach's notations and took the lead of Cantor Fothergill's baton. They just threw out a lot of right notes. Lots of beautiful seed that fell into good soil, with more to come for your voices, too. But the sower in our story sure misses a lot of notes. The sower, it seems, is rather sloppy. Walking out, not even made it to the field, and already seed is spilling out. Out of the bag and onto the path where everyone walks. Every one of those seeds is precious. But either the sower fills his bag so full that seed spills out, or maybe there's a hole in his bag that he's neglected to mend, or maybe he's oblivious to how he's slung the bag of seeds over his shoulder. All this wasted seed. Looks like the sower needs to spend some more time in the practice room. Looks like he needs to keep better track of all those notes, all those seeds that miss the mark. My goodness, seeds are falling onto all the wrong places. They spill onto the path, and the birds eat them up. They spill onto rocky soil where they sprout, but just as quickly wither away as dust into the earth. Some seeds fall among weeds and manage to take root, but soon overwhelmed, choked, and composted into food for those thorny weeds. The sower misses the mark. Or does he? We know that some of the seed makes it onto good soil. It's not clear, however, if this is the good soil of the field to which the sower is headed, or simply good soil along the path he walks. More than likely, it appears just along the path, for the seed is described as falling. Falling kind of accidentally out of the bag of the sower. So, wherever the sower goes, the seed spills out. But here's a miracle. For the seed that falls on good soil along the path, individual heads of grain do pop up, some producing 30 kernels, some 60, some even 100. Now that's an incredible, miraculous, and frankly unbelievable yield for a single head of grain. According to the University of Nebraska Extension Office, modern wheat yields, greater than ancient ones, average about 22 kernels per head. But here, with this sower, we get 30 kernels, 60 kernels, even 100 kernels per head. Well, friends, that sounds like more than enough seed to overcome the seed that misses the mark. More than enough beautiful notes to overcome the ones we miss. Turns out the sower has more than enough seed to bear fruit in good soil that will more than compensate for the seed that misses the mark. The real miracle is that the sower is not worried whether his seed falls onto the road or sidewalk, spills onto the rocks, or falls into the weeds. No, the sower just keeps on scattering seed wherever he goes, always confident that more than enough grain will bear fruit. Clearly, this is no ordinary sower. No, this is a sower who, no matter where he goes, spills and spreads blessing. Blessing upon every place, barren or not. Blessing where others quickly give up. Blessing confident more than enough grain will appear. The seed of this sower, friends, is as abundant as the rain and snow that come down from heaven. And just as the rain and snow do not pick and choose when and where they shower the earth, so this sower does not pick and choose where to scatter his seed. He scatters it everywhere. The sower just picks up the bag and lets the seeds scatter everywhere, just as Bach scatters all those notes in the opening symphonia and delights in hearing them get planted in our ears. Hear then, friends, the good news of the sower. We have a sower, a Savior, who even when we miss our own notes, will keep on playing the gospel notes, the good news that overcomes the wrong notes we play. When we don't understand, when we get scared, when we get overwhelmed, Jesus the sower keeps on spreading the seeds of love and forgiveness and acceptance and peace into our hearts. Jesus the sower doesn't give up on anyone. No matter how many wrong notes we play or how rocky or resistant our hearts, even on the cross where Jesus died in place of his friends, he kept on spreading seeds of goodness, kept on speaking and singing the promises of God. And in a moment, you will hear again these same promises as we remember how in the night in which he was betrayed, sung to notes that Martin Luther sang, Jesus took a bountiful yield of seed that had been transformed into bread and then transformed it again into an offering of his life given for you. Transformed those hundreds of seeds into blessings too many to count for you. Here today, where blessings and seeds spill out, Jesus gives us everything we need, knowing that we are accepted, that we are loved, that we are forgiven, that we are inheritors of eternal life. Here, Jesus the sower is our treasure, our life, our wealth, our friend, our lover, our pleasure, our joy, our crown, our all, our bliss eternally. Amen.
Confident that God receives our joys and concerns, let us offer our prayers for the church, those in need, and all of creation. As snow and rain fall upon the ground, lead your church, O God, to shower seeds of forgiveness and generosity in every place. Move your people to sing your joy and share your peace throughout the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
As seeds spill from the sower's bag, sustain your creation, O God, with your bounty. Send favorable weather, give growth to trees and fields, protect waterways from pollution, watch over our animal companions, and instill in us care for all living things. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
As seeds scatter upon both barren and fertile terrain, spread your peace among all people, O God. Raise up those who work for a just and fair legal system, advocates who speak up for the voiceless, and leaders who work up for the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
As a single seed touches the soil and yields an abundant harvest, send your healing touch on those who are sick, O God. Restore the sick to wholeness of mind and body. Strengthen healthcare workers as they care for those who suffer. Grant insight to scientists who conduct life-saving research, and encourage counselors who care for victims of violence. We pray for those in need among the LSM community, including Ron, Kathy, Megan, and any other people, places, or situations we name before you now, aloud or silently in our hearts. For all these things and for those known only to you, God, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for seeds that fall on every kind of soil, O God. For those who fall on the path, vulnerable and isolated, we pray for protection and companionship. For those who fall on rocky ground without enough to survive, we pray for support and resilience. For those who fall among thorns, knocked down by oppressive forces, we pray for strength and deliverance. And for those who fall on good soil, given all they need, we pray for humility and generosity. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Fortify us by the faithful departed who expressed your beauty, O God. Let good things grow among us, until the day you gather us up in your realm of joy and peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Receive our prayers and answer us, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Morning. Please know that all are welcome to come forward at the direction of an usher. If you hear our Lord's invitation of forgiveness and peace, you are welcome to come forward. You will enter up the chancel steps on the right side, and this morning we offer bread, which you can receive with an open hand and eat immediately. We also offer the common cup, which will have wine, and also a pouring chalice, which will have non-alcoholic wine. So if you want the wine, you need to use the common cup. Non-alcoholic, use the pouring chalice. Individual cups are provided at the top of the stairs should you choose to receive the non-alcoholic wine. There are three stations around the altar, so please move to the furthest open available one as you come forward. We also offer a fourth station here at floor level for those who need it.
Thank you.
field and forest, sea and sky, you are the giver of all good things. Sustain us with these gifts of your creation and multiply your graciousness in us, that the world may be fed with your love through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection open to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. The body of Christ given for you.
Shed for you.
The body of Christ. Thank you. the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Let us pray. We thank you, generous God, for the refreshment we have received at your banquet table. Send us now to spread your generosity into all the world through the one who is our dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The God who calls across the cosmos and speaks in the smallest seed, bless, keep, and sustain you now and to the end of the age. Amen.
Go in peace. Share the harvest.
Thanks be to God.